YouTube, what is going on? Your boy Destroy coming back at you with a banger. And in today's video, we got something that the community has been asking for. I've been reading a lot of the comments. You guys have been asking, yo, drop this video. This video right here is a banger settings video. I'm going to be going through my settings, talking a little about my settings and what a quote-unquote professional or competitive Warzone player uses, the settings that I run in-game. I'm going to also show you guys my controller. We're going to go through my settings, and we're going to talk about it a little bit, and then we're going to show you guys some gameplay with these settings. So start off right here, we're going to show you guys the controller that I use to get it all done. We got a banger scuff controller right here, as you guys can see. That bad boy right there has got two paddles on the back of it right there. It's got some trigger stops right here. That helps me. Trigger stops on that bad boy right there. The trigger stops are absolute fire. So if you do ever decide to use a scuff controller, make sure to use code DESTROY for 5% off. A lot of people have been asking me to drop my settings down below. So hey, we're gonna go over the settings right now as we speak. All right, we're gonna hop right into the game. We're gonna bring the settings out. I'm gonna bring the headset on and we're gonna get into the mode. We're going to go over to the controller settings since we do not use mouse and keyboard right here. Bam. FOV, 120 FOV. A lot of people think that upping your FOV messes up aim assist. It actually doesn't mess up aim assist. 120 FOV. I like it as stretched out as possible. It makes my movement feel a lot better. It makes me feel a lot better as a player. 120 FOV is what I use right here. And then obviously I play on affected. Just switched to affected not too long ago. It says affected is aiming down sight zooms to a value closer to the FOV setting. Only applies to low magnificent levels, less than 3.5, including iron sights. This has a huge difference for iron sights. Basically makes your iron sights exactly how your FOV is instead of zooming it in like independent would. Affected changed my life for the better. Amazing. Love playing on affected. Brightness 55. Nothing too crazy on that one right here. We're going to scroll down a little bit more. I'll go through my settings here. These are not too really insanely important settings. Nothing too crazy here. And then we're going to go over to the graphics. Full screen. Full screen helps me get the best frames. 240 since I have a 240 hertz monitor. 100 FOV. Bam. 1920 by 1080 right here. I'll go through this in case you guys want to copy the settings. Get some bangers. I play with a lot of my stuff on low to try to get the best frames possible. Low settings helps me. You don't need too insane settings on Warzone. Helps me get pretty decent frames inside Superstore and stuff like that. I'll go through the settings here a couple of times. Motion blur off. Make sure you have that off. Motion blur is important. Turn it off. You don't want that on if you play on PC and you're able to have that setting. Here goes audio settings. A lot of people tell me, yo, what audio settings do you use? Yo, what, you know what I mean? What audio settings do you use? Here's my audio settings. High boost. Boost high. 70%. Don't want it too loud in my ear. Then we got the music volume low. Not really a fan of that. Here's my audio settings. A lot of people have been asking for. Bang, right there. Voice chat 200. And then we're going to go over to controller settings. I play on tactical. Let's hear me out on that. Tactical. Yeah, I've been playing on tactical for a long time. Stick layout default. Dead zone 0.07. If I put this too low, you might get a little bit of controller drift. So I leave it at 0.27. 7.7 high sensitivity, but not too high. You see a lot of these players play on 20-20 and stuff like that. Not really too much of a fan of playing on a super high sense. 7.7 allows me to move freely and comfortably around the map without being too high and whiffing too many shots. 7.7 sensitivity. If you can't find your sensitivity and you're looking for a sensitivity that a lot of these pro players or competitive players use, 7.7 is a good place to start because you can work your way up. It's a good spot. Trust me on that. 1.0, I leave this on default. ADS multiplier. And high zoom, low zoom, leave that on. Aim assist on standard. I play on standard aim assist. Most people have that. Scale aim assist with FOV. I do use that as well. A lot of people have been asking about scale aim assist and stuff like that. So scale aim assist, I do have that enabled with FOV. We got these settings right here. ADS behavior, hold. Equipment behavior, hold as well. Yo, contextual tap on the reload. This one right here. Tap the reload or use with priority on use when possible. Listen, Chuck. Yo, you don't want to have to hold square to reload. You really don't want to have to do it. Yo, contextual tap allows you to just press it one time and it gets to reload. A lot of these settings help. Make sure you're looking over these settings right here. Another setting that really, really helped me is a crap ton right here is the armor plate behavior. A lot of people don't understand this setting. apply all settings. Make sure you guys are using this setting right here, apply all. So when you get shot and they break your armor plates off, you do not want to have to hold triangle to continue to put plates on. When you have apply all on, you actually get to just press triangle once and it'll put every single plate on for you. And then you can retype it again and it'll cancel it for you if you need to move away. Slide behavior tap. Auto taxman. I've been using auto taxman for quite a while. You see that it helps my movement a crap ton in the videos. I'd be sliding around like a crackhead, going absolutely insane. Auto taxman, huge fan of that. There's a couple weird things about auto taxman, like using shotguns and dual kimbos. But overall, auto taxman is phenomenal and has helped my movement improve a crap ton. I really, really recommend auto taxman. Parachute auto deploy. I have this disabled. I do. The reason that I have this disabled, parachute auto-deploy, is you get better drops. When you have it enabled and you're falling from the sky, you're coming down from the sky, your parachute automatically pulls at a certain distance every single game. When you do not have auto-deploy enabled, but then you get to pull your parachute even lower than where auto-deploy will allow you to pull your parachute. So you can beat these good players to drops like back superstore garage or window. You can get these better drops, especially early game. Getting these good drops are very, very crucial to getting the gun first, getting even a plate on before they're even landed. So, yo, parachute auto deploy disabled. That was a very, very important change that I had right there. We're going to go back up because I didn't talk about one of my settings right here, which was, I believe, linear. Aim response curve, I use linear. Most people use dynamic. Most people use standard. But your boy right here does indeed use linear. The reason that I use linear, to be quite honest with you, I played 2 years of professional Fortnite, played linear on controller over there, and to be honest, I just thought it was the same thing, so came over here and used linear. In this graph, you can actually see the difference between linear as well as between the three. So that's the graph. I'll show the graph on stream for you right here. Linear. So linear gives you the rotation speed versus the thumbstick movement. Linear goes straight ahead, as you can see right here. Dynamic goes up, comes through the middle, then down, and then up, has a weird path, and then standard goes down and makes his way up. Yeah, that's exactly how that works. I'll read it through what's in the game right here. It says standard, simple power curve map from aim stick to aim rate. Linear says aim stick maps directly to aim rate, and dynamic, reverse S curve mapping for fine. Don't really know too much of what that is, but I'm a linear guy, and I recommend linear because it's absolute banger. And yo, that's the settings right there for you guys that you guys have been asking for. Those are the settings that you guys have been asking for in the comments down below. And bam, we're going to get into some banger gameplay using these settings right here. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and drop down below what you guys want to see next. I've been reading all the comments, been liking them, putting hearts on them, pinning the good ones and stuff like that. So let me know down in the comment section below what you want to see. And I hope you guys enjoyed this banger video right here. And yo, Big D Short is out of here.